This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the area of polygons. I'll explain how to find the areas of squares, rectangles, parallelograms, triangles, kites, and trapezoids. So let's start with the square. If I draw a square box that's 1 inch on each side, then we say that that square has an area of 1 square inch. If I extend that square, the box, so it's got 2 inches on each side, then inside that, there are 4 1-inch squares. So the area of that 2 by 2 square is 4 square inches. Now I can get that area by multiplying one side by another side. 2 times 2 is 4. If I extended the box so it was 3 by 3, I would have 9 square inches. 3 times 3 is 9. So the area of a square is simply the length of one of the sides multiplied by itself, or squared. Okay, so let's go from the square to a rectangle. I'll take the square that I have and I'll extend the base of it so it's now 3 inches long, and it's going to contain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1-inch squares. So the area of that 2 by 3 rectangle is 6 square inches. And I could get that area by multiplying the base of the rectangle, 3, by its height, which is 2. 2 times 3 is 6. So the area of a rectangle is just the base times the height. Now, let's go from that rectangle to parallelogram. So I'm going to start with that basic rectangle that I had and turn it into a parallelogram. I'm going to take a triangular section from the left side and copy it over to the right side. And so now what I've done is formed a parallelogram. That's this shaded portion here. Now this parallelogram has a base that's 3 and a height that's 2. And if you think about it, it should have the same area as the rectangle that I started with, because all I did was take one part of that rectangle and change its position, not its size, I changed its position, so the area of the rectangle, which is now a parallelogram, should be the same. So that means the area of a parallelogram is also going to be the base times the height. Okay, from here we can figure out the area of a triangle. So I'm going to draw that rectangle again. I'm sorry, I'm going to draw the parallelogram again. So the parallelogram had a base of 3 and a height of 2. And all I'm going to do is divide it diagonally in half, so I've formed 2 congruent triangles. Now, each of those triangles, like this one that I'm shading, should have an area that's 1/2 of the original parallelogram, because I divided that parallelogram in half. That means the area of a triangle is going to be the base times the height, that was the parallelogram, divided in half, divided by 2. So for any triangle, we find the area by multiplying the base times the height and dividing that by 2. For this triangle, I would multiply 3 inches times 2 inches, that would be 6, divide that by 2, that would be 3, and that would mean this triangle has an area of 3 square inches. Okay, let's go on to kites. So a kite is a quadrilateral. It's got four sides. Two of the adjacent sides are congruent. They're the same length. And the other two sides are also congruent. They're also the same length. Now, when we measure quadrilaterals, what we normally do is measure the two diagonals. There's a short diagonal and a longer diagonal. So I'll take that longer diagonal. I'll call that D sub 1. That's this one. And that had a length of 3. And the shorter diagonal, I could call that D sub 2, had a length of 2. And now to find the area for this kite, what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to enclose it in a box, in a rectangle, that's also 3 by 2. And if we look at what I've done, I've basically created four pairs of congruent triangles. In each of those pairs, one of the triangles is part of the kite. So for instance, in this upper left-hand corner, this triangle is part of the kite, but this part, this triangle isn't, and these are congruent. So they've got the same area. In the lower left corner, I've got a triangle which is part of the kite, and another triangle with the same area, a congruent one, which is not part of the kite. And that happens on the right side of the kite as well. So now what it looks like is that for this rectangle, half of the area inside is taken up by the kite, and half isn't. So if I know the area of the rectangle, I can divide that in half, and I'll have the area of the kite. Well, the area of the rectangle is the base, which is 3, times the height, which is 2. If I divide that in half, 2 times 3, I'll have the area of the rectangle. I'm sorry, if I multiply that, 2 times 3, I'll have the area of the rectangle. If I divide that, I'll have the area of the kite. Now, the base is the same length as diagonal sub 1. So I can say the area of a kite, is going to be diagonal sub 1, in this case it was 3, times diagonal sub 2. This is like base times height, but I'm going to take it and divide it in half. So it's diagonal sub 1 times diagonal sub 2 divided by 2. And that's going to give me the area of the kite that I've got here. In this case, it would be 3 times 2, which is 6, divided in half, is 3 square inches. Okay, so the last thing to take care of is going to be a trapezoid. A trapezoid is also a quadrilateral. It's got two sides that are parallel to each other. Each of those parallel sides is called a base. And then two other sides are at some angle. So I'll label the base on top base sub 1, and the one on the bottom I'll call base sub 2. And for this one, base sub 1 is 2 inches long, and base sub 2 is 5 inches long. So to find the area of this trapezoid, what I'm going to do is draw a second trapezoid congruent with it and next to it, but upside down. So since it's upside down, the top parallel line will have a length of 5. That's the same as base sub 2. I'll call it base sub 2 prime. That's got a length of 5. And now the bottom parallel line, which I'll call base sub 1 prime, has a length of 2. And what I've got here now is a parallelogram. It's made up of those two congruent trapezoids. I know the area of the parallelogram. The parallelogram has an area that's the base times the height, and the height is 2. Now, the base of this parallelogram, in terms of the trapezoid, is b sub 2 plus b sub 1. Each of the trapezoids is 1/2 the size of this whole parallelogram. So my formula for the trapezoid is going to be, so the area of, I'll draw a little trapezoid here. The area of a trapezoid is going to be base sub 1 plus base sub 2, that's like the base of that big parallelogram, times the height, so times h, and then I want to divide that whole thing in half because that's going to be just half of the parallelogram. Okay, so for a trapezoid, you add the two bases together, the base on top and the base on the bottom. You multiply that, the sum of those two bases, by the height and divide it by 2. The formula is going to be base sub 1 plus base sub 2 times the height divided by 2. And that'll give you the trapezoid's area. Okay, that's it. I'll see you next time.